Now my palazzo pants, as I mentioned earlier, I'm going to be lining these, and the reason for lining these is because the fabric that I'm using is a grip fabric, which probably rightly said by the name grip, it actually sometimes clings to the legs, and it because it's so fine. So in order to stop that, we're going to use this chiffon based scarf fabric to actually line this. Now the point of this is not to actually cover the legs, but just to stop the transparency of the fabric, but to actually make the fold better. So this I'm just folding over. It's going to be a very basic cut, a little bit similar to the pajama type of trousers that we've been doing. So it's not going to have no seaming in this, although the back crotch area is going to be a lot wider, because the last thing we want is the pull on this and it pulls on the seams of the trouser. And I will go around to show you how I would attach this. Now it is fine fabric, so you have to be careful on putting this, because the scissor tends to catch the fabric very easily. Now because I'm cutting two pieces here and they are of varying sizes, I can't dig into it and cut both the ones. So at the moment I'm cutting the top layer. So less, quite a bit less than this. Mark it off at the crotch point as well, and make the back crotch a lot deeper. And then otherwise, we're just basically seaming this the same. Obviously, I want the inside leg less than the outside, but the crotch I want fairly wide so that it's not actually pulling in, and that's basically it. That will go with the front, that will go with the back, and it will give the same identical seaming to what is the only thing I would need to do is, because of the imbalanced area of the crotch, I'm just going to balance this out at the bottom. And that's my piece for the lining of my trouser. Now for the dress. The dress I've cut with this is similar to a kalidar kurta that I did quite a while back. You would have to dig out one of the early tutorials on that, but I will just explain the procedure again. This is going back to several months that I did a tutorial on kalidar kurtas, which was on very fine fabric, which many of you probably most likely have seen the video too. Believe me, I tend to forget how many videos I do and where they are located at times. I've got to try and recall what it is I've done with. That's my palazzo pants. I've got to try and recall what it is that I've done with the actual dress part of this, because I cut this out yesterday and believe me, I often forget where I place things. Now this was the kalidar kurta that I have cut out. It's just a very basic kameez type cut, all in tatters and pieces at the moment. There is the front and the back, so if I separate these, I think you'd be thinking, what the heck is this? Okay, what we have is the piece, this is similar cut to the baby one that I've just recently cut. That's the, you can work it out now, it looks more defined. So we're using the basic infrastructure of the top of the neckline and so on. Same structure for the sleeves. I know you're probably thinking, right, she's not even laid this out properly, but it makes no difference at the bottom because these will hang separately. This has been cut for the inserts. These are the inserts that will be attached to, this is red net that I've combined, and these will be the inserts that will be attached in the as the panels. So a slight little shape on the waistline, not overly done. Cut into, this is double the width of the fabric, so generally for a chemise that is fine. We're going to sew these separately from below. They will be attached on the sleeves and on the neckline. So that's my galese for this dress. That's the back of the dress and that's the sleeves, straight long cut sleeves to go with the whole of the outfit.